गुड मॉर्निंग माई डियर स्टूडेंट्स, एज आई हैव टोल्ड यू टूडे आई एम गोइंग टू अपलोड द वीडियो ऑफ द चैप्टर द स्नेक एंड द मिरर. इट्स माई हम्बल रिक्वेस्ट फॉर ऑल यू पीपल काइंडली वॉच द वीडियो. आई हैव बीन मेकिंग ऑल दिस यूट्यूब वीडियोज विथ ग्रेट एफर्ट. इट रिक्वायर्स ग्रेट एफर्ट, सो प्लीज पे हीड टू इट, वॉच इट एंड गिव योर फीडबैक. The Snake and the Mirror is a great novel. It is the adaptation of a Malayalam novel. Malayalam novel means Malayalam is the state language of state of Kerala. So the conversation starts among the friends who were doctors. There was one homeopathic doctor and he was asked, has snake coiled itself round any part of your body? The conversation was going on and the homeopathic doctor was expressing himself. And the homeopathic doctor told the full-blooded cobra has coiled me. And how the whole story happened, let me explain you. This was the hot summer, 10 o'clock in the night. He has went outside to take his meal and return back. When he returned back, there was sound in the room. And that sound was the familiar sound of the rats. And in the chapter, it is written that the author, the homeopathic doctor, and the rat shared the room. So it was a small rented room. It has no ceiling. It has two windows. And one of the wall opened into the veranda. And with that, he has one big mirror, one small comb, and little kerosene lamp. That particular room which he rented was not electrified. It was a shabby kind of a room. It was very pitch darkness in the room. And somehow or the other, the homeopath doctor was unable to get a sound sleep. So he moved his bed close to the wall. But still he was unable to sleep. So what he did? He moved outside into the open, into the veranda. But that particular day, even the wind god was not available. And his earnings were very meager, very less. He had only 60 rupees with him, a suitcase with few dhotis and shirts, and one solitary black coat and pant which he was wearing. Other than that, he had virtually nothing. And he has also the white vest, which was not so white. So, and his the room, there was the beam in that room, and it was made of roof tiles with the gables, and there was no ceiling in that particular room. And when he sat down onto the chair, he opened the box and took out his book Materia Medica, which was a homeopathic book. And all of a sudden, he started to look himself into the mirror. And that day, as the author is explained, he was a great admirer of the beauty. And he wanted to look handsome. Why? Firstly, he was a bachelor. He was a young man. And he wanted to make an impression that he is the most smartest person in the world. He took up a comb and started combing his hair and parted his hairs. He want to look very great. And three decisions he made. Firstly, he will daily do the shaving. Secondly, he will grow the thin mustache. And thirdly, he will make an earth-shaking decision that he will smile daily. And all he wanted to do that firstly, he was a bachelor, homeopathic doctor, and he was seeking a bride for the marriage. He wanted to get married to a beautiful bride. Rich bride who earned very greatly through his homeopathic practices, but he should be fat, because if by chance he made a slight error, she should not able to catch him. After that, the whole he was thinking about this and that. Suddenly he heard a sound that something from the rooftop ceiling has thudded to the ground. And when he thudded to the ground, he was just sitting on the chair, and all of a sudden he saw a full-fledged, a big cobra was just wriggling himself, wriggled himself to the chair, and slowly and steadily he moved to his shoulders. And the author did not panic, he did not shout, he did not move. He was very terrified, but he was turned into a granite piece, means he was turned into a man without flesh and blood. Slowly and steadily, that cobra coiled himself, slithered himself on the body of the homeopath doctor, and he coiled himself, wriggled himself on his left arm, just above the elbow. And all of a sudden, the hood of the snake was just 3 to 4 inches away from the face of the doctor. It was seems that the death is lurking near him, and it is, and he was telling that it was all due to the God, because maybe he has done something which the God has not liked, and that's why he brought that this snake to his room and over his body. And then he pleaded to the God, "Oh God, it seems that a thick iron laden rod which has been made up of molten fire has been put on his left shoulders when the snake has wriggled him, coiled him, and he was feeling no power in his hand, that he was without power. But all of a sudden, it seems that God has listened to him. He suddenly unwriggled himself, and he just, from that, he unwriggled himself and fell into his lap. From the lap, he went to the mirror. Maybe he was staring at the mirror and he wanted to grow smart. He wanted to grow a mustache, have a mascara, and put the eyeliner or the vermilion. And he was staring at the mirror. And thank God, the author thought, thank God, God has listened to my pleas and my prayers. I was saved. And from that, he ran straight away to the veranda, to the wall, and he jumped over the wall and went to his friend house, where he put the oil all over his body, took the sananam. And next day at 8:30, he went to his room, where he found that everything was clean. The robbers has taken everything except his dirty vest and his tail. He was telling why they have left this dirty vest. They should have even taken this and clean it and wear it. Now his friends was asking that who was that particular person who was chasing you. So the doctor was telling that he was a reedy person. Reedy person means thick and slim person who likes to sprint, means his friends were thinking maybe it was his wife, but he was telling no, it was not his wife. He was a snake who chased me, and after that I have never seen the cobra in my life. So this was the narration of the full chapter, my dear students, and this is the summary which I have written. If you have any doubts, any questions about this, you can ask me anytime. Thank you very much.